Hi everyone, welcome to Between Two Mammoths. I'm here today with Martha Umphrey, the Bertrand H. Snell 1894 Professor in American Government in the Department of Law, Jurisprudence and Social Thought. Martha, thank you so much for being on Between Two Mammoths.
Delighted to be here.
Well, we're lucky to have you here. And one of the things you're doing this semester is you're teaching a class on the law and politics of free speech in the United States. So one of the questions I get sometimes from people who aren't on a college campus is along the lines of, we hear that students now are not really interested, don't value free speech, really aren't interested in promoting free speech, are only interested in canceling each other. What's your experience?
That isn't my experience at all. I think students are anxious about speech, largely because of the social media environment in which we all live now. And because we live here in a small community, people are mindful of the feelings of others. So I think there's a healthy concern for the impact of various kinds of speech among our students. But when you get them in a classroom and really get them going and promise them that they can make mistakes and that they are meant to be exploring ideas, I think they love it. I mean, I can't think of anything more fun than being in a classroom with our students when they really get going on a hard subject.
I'm glad you think it's fun.
Oh, yeah.
We leave that out a lot when we talk about free speech on campus.
Oh, I love it. Yeah, absolutely.
You and I have been talking for the last several months about how do we create a culture on campus where that's the experience of everybody, not just the people in your class. Can you share a little bit about how you're thinking about that? And I know you're working on a particular project.
Yeah, that's right. There is a website with podcasts and videos called Open to Debate. It's an organization that promotes a kind of highly moderated, almost Oxford-style debate format where speakers will take up a question and in a moderated debate sort of explore it from both sides and in a way that's really productive. I showed one of those to my students. I asked them what they'd like to sort of listen to, and we took up a debate on whether or not to expand the Supreme Court's numbers. I had them write about that afterwards, and they really got a lot out of that as a kind of experiment in thinking about how to talk about challenging issues. And I think that that can be a model that we can generalize to the campus more broadly.
That's great. As you think about building that toolkit for not just our students, but generally how to have meaningful discourse, you know, where we have principled disagreement with each other and somehow don't hate each other.
Yeah.
What are your kind of basic principles? What are your rules that you try to hand down?
So one of the things I say to students when they're worried about offensive speech and about harmful or hurtful speech, which is hard to define, is that their first go-to response to something that is bothering them ought to be curiosity rather than fear. So if someone says something to you that you're offended by, maybe you can get to a space where you can say, how did you come to that opinion? I don't understand it, but I'm curious to know how you got there. And that's a mindset that I think can lead to some really interesting conversations.
I want to return as a last question to the fun that you mentioned earlier when you were talking about teaching.
Yeah.
One of your convictions, I know, because I've heard you say it on many occasions, and remind me of it on many occasions, is that this should be fun. That contesting ideas, pushing each other, challenging each other, should be a joyful enterprise. Explain that. For somebody who only experiences it with anxiety or fear, how do we get to the fun?
So I think that we live in a relatively morally earnest climate where people are very serious about the importance of ideas, and I think that's great. But there's a play that comes with ideas that is a part of education and that can occur if you can help students to separate themselves a little bit from the play of those ideas. So, you know, you are not every idea that you think. You can change your mind. We can play with language. We can imagine ourselves in the position of somebody else. And you know, there is a joy in allowing a distinction between feelings and ideas. And then bringing them back together again, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Energy, enthusiasm, you know, and imagination are a part of the way I think this community works at its best.
Well, thank you for all the energy, enthusiasm, imagination, joy, and playfulness that you bring to Amherst College. Lucky to have you as a colleague, and our students are lucky to have you in the classroom.
I'm lucky to be here.